Super Muppet Mode.
Great song, by the way.
Now, here's the question. Do you want to risk going down pit road here?
No.
You can't.
Track position is everything.
If I've not come this far to come this far,
Pace car late is out.
I do not want to put this race in the hands of anybody else at this point in my mind. I like your strategy. I don't want to do it. Send it, is what you're saying. That's what I'm saying. Thank you.
Constitution yellow.
In front and behind him, he is sitting in the fourth, and the yellow flag has come out.
Bunch up the field.
Believe we may have more debris again from some tires that may have been something that came off of the number six of Ty Braun's machine earlier. We see, I thought I saw a couple of cars that may have slowed a little bit. We're going to send our track and safety team out to check for some debris that may have jumped up into the racing group. But the downside to a track like this is
since we're less than 10 to go, these laps, yellow laps, do not count.
It's very hard for it to be out of the way. Gotcha. Makes sense. I mean, you're right. We've seen it between the cars running four wide, intentionally or unintentionally, or simply using a wide sweeping racing line around the course. I need to rethink my thinking when drivers are like, oh, what's the line? You're off about two or three lanes up. No, it's everywhere. It is literally everywhere. If you get there, checking the back
straight. It's dark out here, really. Lights are on.
Down in the middle of the back straight.
It's dark.
Racetrack
looks dark.
I'll pick anything up here, but again,
I don't know how it looks on the screen.
Ready to try to get back to racing again.
In person, it looks dark.
What's got to be going through the mind of Zach Walker right now? What's going through the mind? I'll tell you what's going through my mind. Is like, oh man, you got that twice. You've done this to me twice in these restarts. You're not going to get me a third time. So what is the strategy this sport's going to use to try to prevent Walker
from
gaining an advantage, which he's been unable to do in these restarts? This is the veteran move, Tony Stewart, but if you're Zach Walker and you realize that Tony's waiting all the way to the end of that restart zone, why not just get ready, time it, get to that last bit of the restart zone and just punch it?
I mean, I'm cheating the brake pedal and the gas pedal at that point, right? I'm about three quarters of the way down in the deck with a little bit of brake pedal under me, and they, off we go.
And you see Zach Walker kind of getting pretty far out in front.
Yeah, the two are here.
We're going to be very curious to see how this restart is ruled and judged here. Jackson and Jimmy and Brad to Bernie lurking behind them in fourth and fifth to the line, six lap.
Ignition is out!
What?
Oh my goodness.
Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got problems on the back straightaway. It's
Justin
113 of Justin Heatwave.
Unreal.
And now my favorite words in all of motorsports. Green, white, checker, finish, coming up here at IRP.
So they're going to get Justin out of the way of the back straight, and you have to believe that Stewart groaned when he saw the yellow flag come up. What are you guys doing?
I saw the cloud bubble and the curse words and everything, and I think Logano might have been mentioned in there a little bit, and all that. As Tony Stewart looked like he was going to see the white flag, but right before he got to the start-finish line, the yellow flag clearly displayed before he got there, and that means we're going to add a little bit of overtime.
So last restart, Walker had about as bad. Walker had as good a move as we've seen him have all race on a restart. That was the best thing we've seen him do all night. He needs more than that. You have got to have a restart of an eternity to be able to try to get around Stewart here. As they're trying to get Justin rolling again. As it looks like that car something definitely is amiss, where they can't even get that thing refired and rolling again. For Stewart, you thought that you were smooth sailing and pulling away, and now you're going to have to do it again.
For the Indy 800 presented by Heatwave Visual, but it would also be way cool to be like, man, I totally sent it and I tried everything I could.
Yeah,
you never know.
Yeah,
so there you see. And give a big shout out again to Justin from Heatwave Visual and their whole team doing a great job again setting us up here at the Lucas Oil Indianapolis Raceway Park in the facility here. They're doing a great job. They've got some great interaction down in the breezeway. If you're going to be here again tomorrow, be sure to stop by their booth, check them out. They'll be able to get you hooked up. They can get you some custom built sunglasses in a hurry. And like I said, they're getting some awesome glasses thrown together really, really quickly. So they can look up pretty quickly.
And we are back racing. Two laps to go. They're already three wide. Crashes